Hey, sublimation people, pay attention. I am going to do a video on showing you how to fix really stubborn clogged print heads. I have a printer sitting here. This is my sublimation printer. I literally haven't printed anything from it in just under 2 years. So it's going to be super, super clogged. But there's a trick that I heard from one of my best friends, Heather Martinez. She was told this by a printer repair shop. He showed her how to do it and it works great for her. So I'm going to see if it works on my really, really bad clog. Sublimation is great, but it can be super, super frustrating. And according to YouTube, I have, taught almost 600,000 of you how to convert your printer to sublimation. So it is my duty to help you with these really annoying problems like this. So let's see if this little hack works. Okay, you always start by doing a printhead nozzle check to check the status. I'm actually pretty surprised. My black looks pretty good, but we still need to work on the color. Okay, so you need to go into the maintenance menu, go to settings, maintenance, ink cartridge replacement, and hit start. And then you open the top and then you unplug it. And what that does is it loosens up this for you so you can get in here and work. Right down here are these little, they're like little foam pads. What we want to do is put hot water, like hot steaming water. I actually microwaved this until I felt like that it was hot. I could feel the steam on the top, like the temperature, because it's that steamy is what's going to help soften up the print heads. So I'm just squeezing in water to fill that up. I'm gonna push this back over it, close it, and let it sit for at least 5 minutes. So we're gonna start it back up and do one print head cleaning and then do a print head nozzle check and see how it went. Okay, so we did make quite a bit of progress on this, but I'm gonna do it one more time. I re-warmed up my water. Make sure that you've got steamy water. Okay, so we are on soak and print head cleaning number 3, and it's still not good yet. I think for most people, the little soak method's gonna work after about 2 tries, but this one's been sitting for 2 years. So I'm going to prime the ink and see if that helps. So priming the ink has actually been my go-to in the past. You do the same thing where you say you're replacing the ink cartridges and then unplug it partway through so that you get access to it sliding. So we're gonna do that again and then I'll show you how to prime the cartridges. Okay, so this one, I've got it so you could slide it to the side. The problem is that this doesn't necessarily like to open all the way. So what I do is I just pop the door off and then you take a paper towel, fold it up into thirds and stick it down here along the bottom and then slide. You kind of have to put your fingers in there to make sure it stays under and slide it over so the paper towel is underneath there. Then take an empty syringe and fill it up with air and then go to your problem color. So my black's okay. So I'm just gonna do a little bit on the black because that last one, the black didn't look great. So I'm gonna do about a third of the way down, halfway, and then hold it for like 5 seconds. Pull it out, don't suck. You'll suck out what you just did. Now we're gonna, these other 3 colors are all giving me problems. So I'm gonna do a full syringe worth on each of them. And now I could feel it. There's more tension because this one is clogged. So I'm just gonna hold it like right there just cause I could feel that tension already. The black pushed really easily. The blue did not, it's pushing back. So I don't wanna push too hard on it, so I'm just gonna let it sit here for a second and then we're gonna pull that one out. I'm gonna repeat on the other 2 colors. So the colors are moving, so we're gonna try it again. I'm gonna throw away my paper towel and we're going to print a nozzle check. Okay, we're actually getting really close after doing that priming method. So I don't wanna do any more print head cleanings. I'm going to show you the third trick to helping with the clog, which is printing a purge sheet. I think that is all we need and it'll get them all going. Okay, this is what the purge sheet looks like. These files I got from Cosmos Ink. That's where I get my sublimation ink from. So I'm going to print one of these and see if that helps with the final bit of ink issues we're having. Okay, I just finished printing the purge sheet. I did forget to mention, when you're printing these purge sheets, make sure you're printing them with the premium presentation matte setting. That puts down extra ink, so it's purging better. But this is what we've got. And I am gonna stop. I feel like that's close enough that things are gonna be printing well. I think as soon as you print out one design, it's gonna work out the rest of the kinks on its own. So I was hoping that we were going to get this done faster with less tries, but this printer has been sitting for 2 years. Nobody's going to have a printer clogged as bad as this one. This is where I started. We had 1, 2, 3, 4 print head cleanings and then a purge sheet. So considering this has been not working for 2 years, to be able to make it to this point with only 4 print head cleanings, I consider a win. Okay, so on a final note about this whole process that we just finished, I just showed you 3 different techniques on how to help with clogged print heads. You don't have to do all 3 of those. You don't have to do them in that order. I hadn't tried the steaming method before and had heard really good things about it. So I was hoping that that was going to be some sort of magic fix for my printer. And it wasn't. So we had to move on to priming, which is the priming is normally my go-to. I do that one first. And the purge sheet is what I usually do when I'm super close, but not quite there. So, but you don't have to do all 3. There's really no rules. Whatever works for you, works for you.